Now, I've been meaning to cover firewalls on Ubuntu for a little while, and I figured actually the best thing to do is to go with the long-term release of 18.04, although it should work exactly the same for earlier versions. Now, what we're going to look at is the UFW, which is a very, let's call it friendly version of IP tables, because underneath IP tables is effectively what you're running. So if we look at a clean install like I have here, you'll see that the package is already installed, although it's inactive, which is fine. And I honestly would expect that you look at the manual. So if you put the man UFW, you can see lots of information about what types of configuration can be done in terms of switches, etc. Now, keep that in mind, but at the same time, we will run through a couple of different configurations today to show you what the options might look like in your environment. And we're also going to run through whether you look at the adapter or if you look at an IP address or just the ports, as different types will have obviously different implications. So with that in mind, let's move on to the actual practice part of this, where we go through a couple of rules. So before we start on that, I'm just going to show you an example. Now, the following examples effectively allow different communications. So the first one allows everything to the port that MySQL commonly uses. The second one allows everything to a port range. The third one allows everything to an interface, so one of the network cards on that port. And then the last one, everything from that range to that port. Therefore giving you a couple of different examples of configuration. Now, if we look at this in a slightly more practical way, there are a couple of things we need to do. So before we start, we've got to confirm that the firewall is off, because obviously once you start configuring rules, you're going to start blocking traffic, and that's kind of a problem if you're trying to run services and effectively can lock yourself out remotely. The other one is, it's good to check what the default status is. So in this case, we're going to go into the configuration file and look at, is IP6 enabled? In this case, yes. What's the default policy? So default inbound is actually to drop, and the default outbound is to accept. So by default, all outbound is enabled and all inbound is disabled. So keep that in mind when you're configuring your firewall, that the default policy, whether it is enabled or disabled, and therefore whether you're adding blocking rules, aka you're starting with a whitelist and then working your way back, or if you're starting with a blacklist and then creating whitelisted rules. So as an example, we're working with a blacklist, so we're denying everything by default. So in this case, I'm going to allow port 22, which is the default SSH. Now, normally I would say don't configure the default port for SSH, use something else, but it's just an example in our case, so we're not going to worry too much about that right now. We are also going to enable it, because now we can, in theory, SSH in if we needed, and we can check the status of our rules. So here we can see only port 22 is open from anywhere, which is the other thing. Normally you would not allow from anywhere, but hey, we'll do that. We can also use some of the other commands, such as HTTP or HTTPS, rather than putting in port 80 or 443 by default. Some of those existing common TCP/IP ports are well known enough for it to just accept them as commands. Now, what we've done so far works brilliantly if you just want to allow traffic all the way in. And maybe if it's got a web server, you don't really care where the traffic's coming from and you want to allow it. So that's potentially a fine example. But what if we want to say we only want traffic from a certain range? So in this case, we put the from, and it can be an IP address, singular, or you can put a slash and then have the subnet. So it might be 0/24 as an example to represent a 255.255.255.0 subnet. Now, anyway, we're then allowing this to, and then we can say the interface or IP that we're heading to. So in this particular case, that's going to be any IP on this machine, and we've selected a port of HTTPS. So would you normally do this? It's a more restrictive way of doing it, and it's probably a better way of doing it. But since we already have another rule that says any, this would be a duplicate, and therefore the first one that says any will just overwrite it. So you would not usually have duplicate rules, and it's something to be wary of, that if you have two rules, and the most, in this case, unrestrictive one is potentially going to overwrite the later one. So keep in mind. Now, the other way to do this is to use the network interface. So we can turn around and say, we want to allow traffic, but only to this interface. So in this case, we have three network adapters. We have a physical one for the network. We have a loopback adapter, and we have a Docker adapter. Now, depending on how many network cards you have, you may have many network cards. So in this case, we're going to say, okay, we're going to allow in, on, and then the physical address to, and again, any, on port, and then we simply specify. So very similar to what we had before, but in this case, it's now restricted to whatever the IP address is of that adapter. So very similar to the previous ones, and again, different way doing the same thing. And again, in this case, we've allowed any, so that will again overwrite our previous rule, but we could have used a simple subnet to kind of cut that down a little bit. Now we can also see the number of these rules, so we can also choose to delete the rules that we don't want. So that's a very simple command. We just choose the delete and then we pick the number of the rule. So this is a good way to tidy up rules that don't make sense, and you're simply prompted for a yes no type answer. And as you can see, the rule has disappeared from our list. So this was a very good practical demonstration of how to set up rules simply, although obviously I've got a lot of overlapping ones here that don't make a lot of sense, but it's to get the idea into your head as to how these rules might be configured. So a more realistic one would be to configure it potentially to an IP address or alternatively an adapter on a machine, and then from a particular considered to be safe network. So as an example here, we're going to say this adapter, so whatever the IP address is of that particular adapter, and then from, in this case being my safe machine, so I'm going to say that it happens to exist on a 10.0.0.55. so I'm allowing effectively any traffic at that point from this safe host, which obviously could be okay, but you might say, you know what, I want to have a port in there. So you can do it in either way. You can just say everything from this range, or you can say just from that port. And again, obviously, if we look at the rules, I'm going to have probably a couple of duplicates. So this isn't probably the smartest idea to do it entirely this way, but hey, let's just look at that as an example. Equally, we can do it another way around, and we say from, so where we've got traffic coming in, going to, and in this case put the IP address of this host. So same thing, but reversed round. And again, we can specify the port which it's going to. So we've looked at now different ways of achieving the same thing, some with adapters, some with IPs. Think about what makes more sense for you. Personally, I'm a big fan of using the adapters because it makes things very simple if the IP changes on the machine. Now, hopefully you found this video useful. If you did, hit that like button, and as always, subscribe for more content.